Hello everyone, my name is Vipra Joshi and I am an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management in Electrical Engineering Department. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on subject of computer-aided electric machine design. In this video, I will be explaining no load current of transformer and induction motor. This is unit second topic of sixth semester in electrical engineering branch. No load current of transformer. In idle transformer, there is no core losses. So, it means there is no eddy current and there is no hysteresis loss. But in actual transformer, there is a eddy current loss and also there is a hysteresis loss. So now, let us consider a electric transformer with only a core loss. But there is no copper loss and no leakage reactance of the transformer. We are consider only a coal loss and all are neglected. So when the transformer is energized by the AC source. It means when we apply the AC source to the primary side of the transformer, then the current for magnetizing the core are flowing through the transformer. Okay. This is the flux which link to the core. So, the current for magnetizing the core of the transformer, but the current is not magnetizing current, but it little bit greater than the actual magnetizing current. So here we can say that the magnetizing current has two component. This is the magnetizing current, total magnetizing current. Okay, so it has two component. One component is magnetizing current, which is utilized to magnetizing the core, and the another component of this current is used for the compensating the core loss. Here the current is consumed for the compensating the core loss in the transformer. Because of this core loss component, the current in the transformer on no load condition is not actually the current is not actually by the voltage lag by 90 degree. It is lag by the voltage behind an angle phi is less than 90 degree. So this angle is not properly 90 degree, it is some less than 90 degree. Okay, so this current, magnetizing current, is lag by this voltage at less than 90 degree angle. So we can say the no load current has two component. Here you can see the no load current has two component. One is in phase with the voltage, which is denoted by the IW. Okay, so this is the core loss component, and the another component is the source current denoted by the I mu, and this component is produce the अल्टरनेटिंग फ्लक्स. So the no load current represented by I0 equal to I mu plus IW. Here you can see I0 equal to I mu plus IW. Here I mu is I0 cos theta and IW is I0 sin theta. You can see here this is the horizontal component. So the value for I mu is I naught. This is the I naught cos theta, and for this I naught sin theta. Okay. So when we calculate the resultant of I naught equal to under root of I mu square plus IW square. This is the total no load current at the transformer, which is the combination of two component. Okay, two component is I mu and IW. Okay, so IW, here IW is the coal loss component and I mu is the another component which is used to produce the alternating flux. Now the no load current on the induction motor. The current is withdraw when the induction motor does not have any mechanical load. It means when we connect operation of the induction motor, there is we do not connect any load, any mechanical load. Okay, so now the load current is around the 40 to 50% of the full load current. This no load current is around the 40 to 50% of the full load current. Okay, so this is the diagram of the phase current, this is the diagram of the phasor diagram of the induction motor. Here you can see this is the flux and this is the voltage. Okay, so this is the receiving sending end side voltage, or this is the receiving end side voltage. Okay, and here the total current is the combination of these two current. Now we can say the I0 means I naught, no load current, equal to under root of Im square plus IW square. Here it no load current has two component. First is magnetizing current component, which is denoted by the Im, and second is iron loss component, which is denoted by the IW. Here the magnetizing component, it means the magnetizing current is produced to require the amount of flux in the different part of the machine. So this gives the flux, okay, on the different part of the machine. So here if we want to calculate the total flux due to the magnetizing current, okay, if we want to calculate the magnetizing current, it is calculated from the magnetic circuit of the machine. Okay, so we can say here the ampere turn for all the magnetic circuit such as stator core, stator teeth, air gap, rotor core and rotor teeth gives the total ampere turn. It means we calculate the total ampere turn by all the magnetic part, and we can say we individual calculate the all the magnetic part ampere turn, then we adding the all the ampere turns due to the all the magnetic part. so it gives the total ampere turn. So we can say the magnetizing current is denoted by the Im equal to P ampere turn 30 upon 1.17 kW into TPH. Here P is the number of pairs of the pole. Here AT 30 means total ampere turn of the magnetic circuit at 30 degree from the center of the pole. And TPS is the number of slot turn per phase. So this is the formula for the calculating the magnetizing current. Now what is the iron loss component in the circuit? It is responsible for the supplying the iron loss in the magnetic circuit. So it is calculated from the no load losses because it supply the iron loss. Okay, so formula for the iron loss component is IW is total number of load loss upon 3 into phase voltage. Okay, so this is the diagram. Here V1 is the supply voltage, this is the primary side circuit. Okay, so this is the resistance, inductance, current I1 is flowing through the primary side. Okay, so here is the RC, resistance due to the capacitive part. Here the resistance due to the magnetic part, means inductive part. Okay, so here the current IC flowing and here the IM flowing. Now if we want to calculate the no load test for the induction motor, here we know that in the three phase power. Okay, so total input power supplied to the induction motor is denoted by the W0. It is in the watt. The unit of power is watt here. So in the three phase condition, it is the value of the power is root 3 into V1 I0 into cos phi naught. Here phi is the angle and cos phi is the power factor. And phi is the power factor angle. Now here we can see V1 is the line voltage and I0 is the no load current. And if we want to calculate the rotational knot, it is the supply power minus S1. Here the value of S1 is, it means these losses are the stator winding losses. And the formula for getting the stator winding losses is NPH, means N phase, into I square R1. Here NPH is the number of phase. Okay, I is the current and R1 is the resistance. Okay, so the various loss like windage loss, core loss and rotational loss are the fixed, which is calculated by the 3I square R. Okay, here 3 I naught square into R1, where I0 is the no load input current and R1 is the resistance. So by this we can calculate these losses. And R1 is the resistance of the motor. Thank you.